Let's discuss how to check whether a number is Armstrong number or not. Given a number x, write a code to check whether a number x is Armstrong number or not. And what is Armstrong number? An Armstrong number is an n digit number that is equal to the sum of the nth power of a digit. For example, if the input number is 153, so it has 3 digits. So let's do the sum of the nth power of its digits. So 1 to the power 3, 5 to the power 3, and 3 to the power 3. If we do the sum, so it is equal to 153. So the original number is 153, and the sum of nth power of a digit is also 153. So it's an Armstrong number. Let's take another example. So the input number is 15. It has 2 digits. So 1 to the power 2 and 5 to the power 2. So let's do the sum. And the sum is 26. What's the original number? So the original number is 15. And the sum of nth power of a digit is 26. So both are different. So it's not an Armstrong number. Let's take another example. So this is the last one. So the input number is 1634 and it has 4 digits. So let's do the sum of nth power of a digit. So 1 to the power 4, 6 to the power 4, 3 to the power 4, and 4 to the power 4. If we do the sum, it is equal to 1634. So it is equal to the original number. So it's an Armstrong number. So this is the problem statement. And now let's think how we can solve this problem efficiently. Let's discuss the solution. So we know that an Armstrong number is a number that is equal to the sum of the nth power of its digit. So the first step is to calculate or count number of digits present in a number. Once we know the number of digits present in a number, then the next step is to calculate sum of nth power of its digits. And once the sum is calculated, we can compare the original number to the calculated sum. If both are equal, then it's an Armstrong number, else it's not. Suppose an input number is 153 and we have to verify whether this input number is an Armstrong number or not. So what's the first step? So first step is to count number of digits present in this number. So I am calling this method count number of digit and passing this number as an argument. And this method returns the number of digits present in this number. And to count the number of digit, the logic is very simple. I am running this loop while the value of num is greater than 0. And at each step, I am reducing this number and incrementing the value of length. So initial value of length is 0. Now this, suppose the number is 153. So the initial value of this num variable is 153. And this number is greater than 0. So at this step, I have reduced this number to 15 and incremented the value of length to 1. Then in next iteration, this is reduced to 1 and the value of length is incremented to 2. And in next iteration, the number is reduced to 0 and it is incremented to 3. And after that, we came out of this loop and returned the value 3. So original value of number is 153. After first iteration, it reduced to 15. After second iteration, it reduced to 1. And after that, it reduced to 0. And we incremented the value of length. And when we came out of this loop, so the value is 3. So we return 3. So then now the value of length here is 3. Now the second step is to compute the sum of the nth power of its digit. So here is the logic to compute or to find the sum or to calculate the sum of nth power of its digits. So the value of temp is 153, and again this while loop runs if the value of temp is greater than zero, and at each step we are doing some operation. So first we are extracting digit, then the initial value of sum is zero, and in some variable we are adding sum plus the power of each digit. So let's dry run this code. So the value of temp is greater than zero. So when we do the modulus 10 with 153, let's say with this, so the digit we got as 3, and the initial value of sum is 0, and let's do the power of this digit with length. So the value of length is 3 and digit is 3, so 3 to the power 3. So we get 27, and here we reduce this number to 15. So in next iteration the value of temp is 15, and again the digit we extracted here is 5, and this time the previous value of sum is 27, and let's do 5 to the power 3, which is 125, and let's do the sum, and the sum is 152. Now again we reduce the value of temp to 1 when we divide by 10. So in next iteration temp is greater than 0, so the digit we get here is 1. So if you do the modulus 1 modulus 10, so the result is 1. So we get 1 here, and then the previous value of sum is 152, and now we do 1 to the power 3, so it is 153. And in next step when we divide 1 by 10, it is 0. So in next iteration this condition is not true, so we came out of this loop. So we get the value of sum, which is 153. So the value of sum here is 153, and the original value, which is num, is also 153. So we return true. So this is an Armstrong number, and if you see the main method, see this main method, I'm calling this function as Armstrong. So it's a static method, and I'm passing this number as an argument. So, and here I get boolean value as a result. So when sum is equal to num, then it's returned true. So I get true here, and it's an Armstrong number. So the we print Armstrong number. So this is how we can solve this problem, and I'll share the code link in the description box. So please make sure you check the description box. And that's it for this video tutorial. For more such programming videos, you can subscribe our YouTube channel. You can visit our website, which is https://webrewrite.com. Thanks for watching this video.